very good. Tuna is just throwing rice everywhere.
Good morning, everyone.
Welcome to a new episode. Today we are in Udaipur in India. What are we gonna do?
Okay, I'm super excited today because we're going to be trying our first Rajasthani thali at Nagraj Dining Hall. It was recommended by someone on Instagram, actually.
Mikash, a big shout out to you. Thank you for
Thank
the recommendation
so
here in Udaipur. So if you're not following us on Instagram, send us some recommendations because we love hearing from locals.
Yes.
Absolutely. Right now we're gonna take our tricycle and we're gonna head over there and wow, we're so hungry. Let's go.
Thank you.
We made it, Tuna.
We made it. We're on the Thali Street of Udaipur. There's two restaurants. There's Gordon's and there is Nagraj. We've been recommended to try Nagraj.
And Gordon.
And Gordon.
Both.
Oh shoot.
But I think we're gonna start with that one.
I don't know if you can have two Thalis in one sitting. I think that's a lot. We'll see. If we're super hungry, we might go to the other place as well.
Or if that one is full. But we gotta say we don't know too much. So if you know all about Thalis, let us know in the comments.
What I think Thali is like a mixed plate. That's what it means. It's a mixed plate.
But let us know how to eat it, if we're doing it correctly. We'll ask inside, but just in case, if you see something, let us know. Ready?
Yeah, let's go. Do you know what it reminds me of here? It reminds me of the dim sum restaurants in Chicago, in Chinatown, you know?
Oh, because of the queue?
Yeah, because of the queue and then the multiple floors that you have as well. It's just like the big meal night.
What are we supposed to do? That is the question.
Someone's helping us, so it's good.
Guys, all that food looks so good around us. I'm super excited.
It does remind me of those big restaurants in Chinatown where we have this communal dining feel. There's lots of families. I think we're one of the smallest parties. The first things first, you get your big platter here of empty little bowls and they come around and it looks like they're filling them in with, I guess, some curries and sauces and all this good stuff. I don't know yet because mine's still empty. Oh. What is this called?
Kochori.
Kochori.
Thank you, kochori.
You eat it like that?
Yes.
Yeah?
We got our first item, but we're waiting for the chutney. What is this one?
Gulab jambu.
Gulab jambu.
Okay,
we need a translator.
They're sweet this.
The sweet one?
Sweet. Super sweet.
For after. So we're very lucky because we have an awesome translator with us because I can't remember all the names of the dishes sitting next to us. So.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So we have the udi with the chutney. This looks really good. I kind of want to eat it now.
You eat this one with the chutney also?
No.
This is
one.
Okay, cool.
And
I don't know if I mentioned, but you pay once and it's unlimited. So you can refill as much as you want, if I'm correct. And it can get super filling. You wanna know?
Really? No?
Oh yeah, it's gonna be good.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Are you ready to try tuna?
I am super hungry
Look
right now.
At that, guys.
First Rajasthani
Let's
thali.
Lift it. Let's lift it for you guys to see. So I'm gonna try that one. The first one we got, tuna.
Yes.
Did you try it?
No, not at
I'm
all.
I'm gonna try it with a little bit
I'll
of
chutney. I'll try it with
you. Let's try it together. There's some green sauce here. That looks so good.
Look what's inside, by the way. It looks like there's the lentils, like yellow lentils inside.
Oh, this is good.
Mm. Oh, nice. Thank you very much. We just got another one!
We just got a refill. Mm. Wow. It's so flavorful.
That's
it's
nice.
Crazy.
You know what it reminds me of?
What?
It reminds me of a round samosa. It's baked, no potato. The starch is coming from the lentils.
It's a little bit flaky. I don't know if you can see on the inside. It's just absolutely delicious. He said try that one and you dip it in the dal.
Okay, so go
That's
ahead.
That's what
then.
Our neighbor was saying.
Great, go ahead.
What are you
trying? So I wanted to try my flatbread.
We're gonna be fighting over what to try. I think that's a naan. Okay, let us know. Let us know if it's grown up.
But there's, I have some chana, so it's a chickpeas. Whatever that is, that chickpea thing is delicious. It's so nice. Whoa. It's a little bit citrusy. Mm. It's not too spicy.
This is delicious.
It's a different flavor profile than I've had before.
I want to say the chickpea is amazing because it's literally melting in your mouth. It's not crunchy, the cooking is perfect. There's no skin to it also.
It is so good.
We're gonna do a speed run through because right now I feel like we're just shouting stuff at you. So here's what's gonna happen. We're gonna agree to taste what. You say your thoughts, I say my thoughts, and you guys just watch. How about that?
Let's go. Down. Let's go.
Boom. Dip it in whatever you want. That's standard good. It's very light, in my opinion.
Very light. Sauce is very light.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Because there's two types of dals that we had. We've had this kind of dal, which seemed boiled, but then we've also had a dal fry. The dal fry always seems to be a little bit more flavorful than the actual dal here that's boiled. I really like it. It's a nice, lighter dish.
It's very liquidy versus some that are very thick. That's
true.
What I would say.
That's totally true. Okay, next dish, potato. Mmm. Potato's really nice. Again, it's not too spicy and overpowering. The spices there are very subtle, I think.
It's nice, it's round. It's very round. I really love it.
You
wanna try the paneer?
Is it like a masala?
I don't know. I'm gonna try the paneer here. Ooh, I don't know why. The sauces of the paneer are always so, so good. Really, really love it.
The guy with the paneer is over there. It's so nice.
We are going to try the okra. Ooh, the okra is salty.
I was just gonna say, that one is a little salty for me.
But guys, okra usually is super slimy. What I've realized is that it's not slimy at all.
No.
I don't feel any sliminess to the
No,
the
here
okra.
I think they cook it in a certain way where it's really nicely cooked. I want my guy to come back. The paneer guy, come back.
Mm, so good.
Here, what are your thoughts?
Okay, my thoughts so far is like 10 out of 10. I'm super excited. This is so good. There is a bunch of stuff to try and eat. It's just so fun to eat. Trina is just throwing rice everywhere. But apparently that's how it goes down here.
Mm. These things are made from semolina.
They're
like
really?
Little grains. Yeah.
Let's try them.
Oh yeah.
It looked like a rice cake.
Yeah, but it's not rice.
At first. Wow. Okay guys, we're gonna dig a little bit deeper into our dishes. I think we're gonna come out maybe rolling out of the restaurant.
We'll tell you how much this costs too, because I don't know how much it costs.
No warning guys, we did it totally wrong. You might have seen us use a little bit of our left hand. You're only supposed to eat with your right hand. That hand is usually improper. It's more like for toilet stuff, if I understood correctly. So I'm very sorry if you use that hand. We will practice of breaking food with only one hand.
And you guys, I was looking around the restaurant and I noticed that people were just said, okay. Oh, it's okay, thank you. I noticed that people's left hands were totally static, and then that's when I kind of realized, oh no, I'm doing this wrong. So what I understood is that if you look around and they give you a spoon and people in the restaurant are eating with a spoon, it's probably a more, let's say, upscale place, so that you should just do what they do.
I don't have a spoon. Oh!
You know what? I don't know. I think it's like a combination of both here. Oh, this looks so good! Yeah.
Oh, very good.
Alright, note to everyone. Pierre, this is not a naan, it's a chapati. There you go. But tell them the way that it works. Okay, so literally we're eating here, and Pierre was right from the beginning, it is a buffet, because they literally come around, and if they see that you're done with your rice, or you're done with your chapati, or you're done with any kind of curry, they just refill it. And sometimes if you don't want it, they'll just refill it anyways. So get ready
and
to be full.
It's the best buffet, because you don't have to go to the buffet. The buffet comes to you. Oh yeah.
Guys, do not wear a white shirt to come have
tally. Bad idea. Can you try the sweet ball?
Yeah, I tried it a little before.
Is it? I'm curious, are you supposed to eat it just as a dessert or like in the middle? I've seen people eat it in the middle, so what would you say, Trina?
It's like, okay, so here's what I think. It's definitely a fried dough ball. The interesting thing is the syrup has gone to the very core of the dough ball and it's changed the consistency of the dough a little bit. So it's not even like a bread.
It's a dough ball that's in a syrup jacuzzi.
It's gone into the core of it, where it tastes a little bit mushy now. Things to note though, it's not, it is very, very, very sweet, but it's strange because I feel like if it wasn't so heavy, I could have a lot, but it's just very, very heavy.
Maybe it's because you had a lot of spices and it balances out.
I think I developed my own technique for eating it because like I said, it's very sweet. It's also very rich, but for whatever reason, it's sweet, but it's not like sickly sweet. Because sometimes when you get sweets that are too much, you just can't eat it. The technique literally was to just take little bites continuously, and then it's just all gone. It just disappears. I don't know how it's just gone. It's addictive.
And then you pass out an hour later.
It's like addictive. Like, really?
We're done, guys, and right now we're just getting a few of those, I'm gonna call them rinse mouth. It was very good. See you guys, bye. Thank you. And yeah, apparently that restaurant has also two locations, so it's something to look. There's another one and there's this one, and the price is $2.30 per person. It's literally unlimited, as much as you can eat. I heard in the past it was around $110, but obviously the prices went up. $110 seems really cheap. It's just like $1.50. Crazy. Oh, so good. It's delicious. What do you think, Trina?
It was really, really, really nice. Yes.
It was excellent. And look at that, just behind me, under the big pot right now, they're making the bowls, the sweet ones that you were talking about.
Yeah.
And basically they're simmering into a very hot pot with, I guess, like syrup, should be sugar.
Oh, God.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Does not look happy.
No,
so
not at all.
We're gonna let you go here for today,
yeah.
Guys. If you like that video, leave it a big thumbs up. Let us know in the comments what is your favorite food in India, what we should try.
Sorry.
And all-